That is Anthony Heron.
Yeah. What's going on over there? What's
I
doing?
Don't know. This is strange.
Is that a dead body?
I don't know. I don't know. But here we are on the ninth floor and looking out over an empty lot, and there looks to be something close to that in the empty lot.
Is that, I'm asking you, is that a dead body out there?
It's concerning looking out that window.
Was Shane just dead? Did Shane go down there and check it out? So, Shane, what's going on down there?
Oh, it is a dead guy.
It is?
Oh, no.
Either dead or very
sleepy,
passed out, but he's face down, and there's some kind of darkness around his head. I don't know what kind of fluid that is, if it is a fluid.
Oh, my
like
God.
Blood, maybe.
Oh, my
I can't
God.
Speculate.
Because if that's the case, that's an execution, because it's not like somebody
Wait,
jumped.
You can't speculate after just speculating.
We're like a quarter mile away, Dan.
I did go check, and it is absolutely a dead guy. Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
I do think I need some help. I think it's probably time.
All right. We'll help out Dan, and we'll report back on whatever situation is occurring on the other side of the street. It's the Bernstein and McKnight Show on 670 The Score.
All right. We have an important update.
This is incredible.
This I've never seen anything like my life.
Nope.
Okay. So we had a dead body down here in the empty lot here off of Stetson at Lower Lowest Wacker.
The very lowest.
The very lowest.
That's important to remember here
right
as we tell you the story.
Off of Prudential Plaza. So the guy's lying face down in the dirt. And the cops came, but the cops were on the wrong level of Lower Wacker.
They were on the middle level.
The middle. So they're on lower, but at Lowest Wacker. So the SUV, we saw the SUV pull over to look down a level at him. The lights are going. The blue lights are going on the SUV. So he's still lying there. Then the police realize they're not on the lowest level to go investigate the body. So they leave to ostensibly to go. In the intervening time, for the time the SUV leaves, the body...
Which was motionless.
But motionless, face down, like nose down,
face into the dirt,
face in the dirt. He gets up and then calmly and with a purpose walks to a hole in the fence of this fenced in area, gets under the fence and walks west. Shortly thereafter, for the moment he leaves our sight, the SUV with the lights going pulls up, drives right past the spot in the fence, drives apparently right past that guy, and they get out of the car and they look at the fence expecting to see the dead body. But they had just driven by the guy who was the dead body, and now the cops are standing around looking at each other.
They missed him. Way to go, not dead guy.
Whoever not dead guy is.
Fire truck pulling up now.
Oh.
Once he got up, he did a little bit of a Travolta Pulp Fiction, looks this way, looks that way, and then walks out.
I would love to know the chatter between the officers, between the time.
Oh, on the scanner?
I get down there, and I look over the ledge, you know what I mean? And the guy's laying there, face down. So I get in the I gets in the car, we drive down there, and now he's gone. So I came back up to where I was before, thinking that perhaps if I come to the second level again, he'll reappear, and he's still out there. I am stumped. I'm absolutely stumped.
It's so amazing.